step between the light, please. That's great. Okay, smile. Do you have anything else you could wear? Could you try something else on? No. Tell you what, how about just no shirt at all? Let's try that. Nope, with this light, we're just gonna need you to lose that shirt. I'm just not feeling that shirt. Yeah, that's gonna work better. Here we go. Oh, those pants don't work with the lighting. Could you roll up your pants? Or, you know what, just take the pants off, too. Those pants just aren't working for me. If you want a passport, you're gonna have to lose the pants, pal. Okay, that's good. Really nice. Yes, very nice. How about we lose the underwear?
You sick son of a bitch! Stop him! You'll never take me alive!
Shalom, first and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Bashem, Makah, Kadash. Double honor to our elders at GMS who rule well. Peace and salutation to the elect. Akim on the four corners, put some truth and sincerity. Peace be unto you. This is a short clip from actually, it's a video game called Stick of Truth. It's a South Park based off of, you know, the TV show, the cartoon. And I just want to point out that, you know, in the game, it's got a pedophile in the game. And in the video, you know, it gives you an option to keep your clothes on and keep your clothes off. And as you can see, he was saying, let's see.
I'm just not feeling that shirt.
Oh, okay, this is a little bit before.
Nope, with this light, we're just going to need you to lose that shirt.
See, so he had an option to put his shirt on or keep his shirt on or remove it. He clicked keep it on. But if you look at the next very next frame.
I'm just not feeling that shirt.
See, the only options he got is remove shirt or remove shirt. And you know, this is what Babylon has come to. You know, you got actually, you know, pedophiles in video games. I'm about to go over here. I want to say which market it is. Let's see.
So that we can help them, you know, provide a circle of support for them. There's not a lot of people that are out doing what I do. There's just a handful of us doing it.
What was your reaction when you first decided to show your face on the internet, so to speak?
What was the reaction from the public, or?
Yeah.
Well, I got a pretty public backlash, but by the same token, I actually got a lot of support privately. I got hundreds and hundreds of emails from people who were very supportive.
Look, this guy most likely, I'm saying agent, and one of the things that he's doing is he's advocating for pedophilia. And as you can hear, he said he got a lot of backlash, but he said there's a lot of people that was in support of it. You know why? Because this is, you know, Babylon the Great, you know, modern day Sodom and Gomorrah, where all type of, you know, wickedness goes on in this place. So this guy basically has this movement where it's called like virtuous pedophile, which a pedophile is not virtuous, can be virtuous at all. You know, the law, keeping laws, that your commandments, that's what makes us righteous. And top of that, there's no such thing as a righteous Edomite. You know, so here you got this guy. Let me put a little bit more.
A lot of them were people who were survivors of abuse.
Are you worried about your own personal safety in putting yourself in the public eye?
You know, I used to be worried about my safety, and I do take some precautions. I carry this pocket knife with me just in case I ever get attacked. It's never happened, but, you know, I've got it if I need it. It's a spring blade.
You know, so you keep a knife on you because, like, this goes to show. If you're in a lifestyle, and you're engaging in some type of lifestyle where you feel where just simply living your lifestyle, you got to get protection, because a lot of homosexuals do that. You know, you got these transgender, they keep, you know, little knives and shanks in their pocket because they never know who might run up on them. And same with him. But you're engaged in a lifestyle where you actually need to protect yourself from just simply just being you. And that's even furthermore. You know, they like to compare, oh, well, there was a time where people looked down on black. Hey, look, us Israelites, you know, us melanated, kissed by the sun Israelites, that's not a choice. That behavior that he's doing, that completely is a choice.
There might be some crazy out there who decides to attack me. Plus, I have this, so, you know. That tends to deter most people.
Yeah. Now, can you imagine a kid, you being a kid and this fucking freak is attracted to you? Just imagine the type of, psychologically, what it would do to a kid. This fucking hairy, disgusting, like he probably ain't even took a shower. In fucking 5 weeks playing World of Warcraft online. And that's your first introduction to sex as a child. Is somebody a fucking sick freak like this?
I was born without my right hand. It just didn't grow properly. I have to wear this. Slips right back on.
And that's a blessing. That's literally a blessing that the Most High, well, it's a curse to him, but it's a blessing that he isn't, you know, born with two hands.
Just like that.
Basically, his arm withered away, or didn't even get a chance to wither away, because it never fucking developed. And you don't somehow think that this is, you know, the hand of the Most High.